by Gerard Galanto. We'll open it up for questions.
What's it like on your first day?
Well, it's hectic today, obviously, with all the physicals and medicals and everybody running around, but it's fun. I mean, you're seeing all your players, you get to talk to some players and meet some players for the first time, so it's exciting.
When will you address them as a group for the first time, and what's the process of this now becoming a team?
We have a team dinner tonight, and some of the, you know, we'll go over some of the rules and trying to be on time and getting set a schedule for all the guys, but you know, I'll address them tomorrow before the ice session. We have a video session, a quick video session, and you know, we'll talk about what our plan is and what we want to do here in the next 2 or 3 weeks to get ready for the season.
What's the plan to win the cup, Coach?
That's quick. One day at a time. First day, yeah. No, it's one day at a time, and you know, let's have fun and let's work hard and let's get better every day. That's all we want to do.
How does it feel to coach Marshall again?
Sorry?
How does it feel to coach Marshall again?
No, it's good. He's a good hockey player. I had a little bit with him last year, obviously the first 2 months of the season, and Jonathan took advantage of an opportunity he had in Florida last year when Huberto got hurt in the first line. He played there and he took advantage of it, and that's what we want from again this year. You know, we had a 30-goal season last year, so not a rookie, but basically a rookie, and you know, he's got confidence, and he's a guy that can put the puck in that. So we're looking forward to having him, and you know, hopefully he'll do the same for us.
Can you talk about a guy like Nate and the importance of having guys in your locker room who've been on winning teams, who if things do get rough in an expansion year, they will not allow guys to buy into that?
Yeah, no, that leadership is huge for us as an organization and as a coach. I mean, I like the veteran players, I like character guys, and like you said, Fleury's won 3 Stanley Cups, so good. You know, that's really important, and he's a good leader, he's a good person. So, you know, when you have some of those tough times, every team has them, but we're an expansion team, we're going to have some tough weeks, and, you know, we just got to fight through it and stick together as a group and fight through those tough times. So it's important for me, and it's important for our organization to have the veteran leadership guys.
Nation.
Nate?
Yeah.
I don't know him as a person yet. I met him, but from what I hear, he's an easygoing, fun-loving guy, and he's going to work hard, and he's a good hockey player. So, you know, I'll get to know those guys over the next couple of weeks and know more about them, but I know he's a good hockey player.
Coach, on that note, because you don't know these guys personally, all of them, are there expectations? Do you have expectations for them, or do you maybe just kind of temper them?
No, there's no expectations. I mean, expectations is to come to the rink every day and get better and work hard as a team. And I like my players to be good people. And I like my players to come to the rink every day and try and get better. And when we play games, you know what? We're going to work hard, we're going to compete hard, and give ourselves a chance to win every night. So that's, for me, it's not about trying to win 40 games or 30 games or 20 games, whatever it's going to be. It's about trying to get better every day and trying to compete and battle and win every night.
Those are asked a couple of the guys to be that one-on-ones about their expectations, and they had said, no, it was more or less just getting to know their personalities. Is that important to you to get to know them outside of hockey first so you can blend personalities?
Yeah, I mean, like I said, I still haven't met most of our players yet. You know, you talk to them on the phone a little bit and say hello to them, but we're a new group. I mean, it's not like you're coming back to a team, you know, like when I was in Florida. I mean, you come back and 19-year players returned from last year. This year, it's all new players. I mean, I know 3 or 4 guys personally, but besides that, it's going to pump in the guys. And I'm probably going to call them around name a few times on the ice, and they'll sort of laugh and giggle, and we'll get to know each other, and we'll work hard and have fun.
Kurt, give me a short time frame for camp, getting to October 6th, and the fact that, you know, this thing is so wide open. Would you expect the intensity to be ratcheted up even more than normal in a normal training camp? And if so, is there a line that can't be crossed where guys are trying to make such a good impression that if you put somebody else's health or safety in jeopardy trying to make this team?
No, the way, I mean, with training camp now, you're playing exhibition games 3 days into our training camp. So it's not like, I'm going to tell our guys, the first 2 days we're going to scrimmage a little bit, we're going to have hard practices. But there's no such thing as fighting, there's no such thing as cheap hits or any hits when guys aren't ready. They're going to play exhibition games, everybody's going to have a chance to play in the exhibition season. And if you're a tough guy or a physical guy and you want to show what you can do then you can do it. But we want you to play hockey and show your skill and speed and play the game the way you're supposed to be playing. So I'm not looking for guys to go out there and you know, try and impress people with fighting or trying to take somebody's head off with a big hit. That's not going to happen.
Because you don't have much time, obviously the game's in 3 days. Do you, how fast do you have to get these lines put together and decide who's going to play together?
I'm not worried about that. Seriously, for the first three or four exhibition games, we'll put guys in different situations and play different combinations. And either the last two or the last three games, then we'll try and put a line combination together, and that's how we like to start the season. So we'll see where it goes, but really that's not that. It's not a major thing for me right now.
Where are Schmidt and Neil health-wise, and did Grabowski, what's Grabowski's status?
I have no idea, to be honest with you. I haven't got an update from our trainers. Schmidt is, from everything I know, he skated the last couple of days, and he said to me he's real good and he's working out upstairs. So the other two guys, I haven't seen them, to be honest with you. Because I haven't been around. We were in LA the last couple of days, last 3 days, and so I'll find out from our trainers.
Gerard,
hopefully I can tell you some more.
Sorry. With regard to James, just having a guy who's scored 40 goals, who consistently can score 20 goals for a team, especially as an expansion team in the first year, maybe. What does that do for you guys in terms of competitiveness, in terms of, you know, having a chance to put the puck in the net and, you know, stay in games, I guess?
Yeah, no, I mean, he's a real important player, and we're real happy to have him, but like we said, if we're going to do anything this season, it's going to take 23 guys or 30 guys, you know, some call-up guys also. So obviously our veteran players and our leadership and the guys that scored some goals in this league are going to be real key to us. But for me, it's, if we're going to have success, it's going to be about every night, you know, everybody that's playing in the game is going to have to give our best effort, and that's the only way we're going to have success in this league.
Because you don't know the guys, who makes the call on who goes to the preseason games and how you adapt to it being that quick?
No, we're going to, as an organization, we'll get together out here to practice and decide who's going to play the next exhibition game. So we have a plan on certain guys going to play a certain round of games, and we know we're going to play all seven of them, that's for sure, but some guys might play a little more than other guys, and obviously you know certain guys that are going to be on your hockey team, and they might not have to play as many. They might play the last couple and see ready for the season. So we're going to give our guys an opportunity, and there's a lot of guys fighting for a few spots in their roster, so it should be interesting.
At least for the first few games, is the plan kind of to get the young guys out there on the ice more than the veterans?
Well, the rookies just played two games, and then you're going to see another game in Vancouver with a lot of young guys, and then after that we'll decide what direction we're going to take. But yeah, we're definitely going to get the chance to play some games.
How long do you expect the kids to be around?
And it's day to day, we'll see how they get along. If they're playing well and they're good enough to make their team, then they'll be around a long time. So it's, George and their staff will be watching the camp very closely. We'll be working on the ice, and we'll make those decisions.
Coach, how important do you think this franchise is to the Vegas community who've been waiting for a major pro sports team for decades?
I think it's huge. I mean, we're excited. I mean, obviously the ownership and the management staff worked hard the last 2 years to get the team here, and last year was all about working hard for the expansion players that we drafted, and so they worked really extremely hard, and, you know, today is really a big official day for us to, you know, start our training camp and get ready, and then tomorrow we're on the ice, so all the players here, everybody's excited, and we can't wait to get going.
Any more questions for Turk? Cool. Thanks,
Coach. Thanks, Coach.